let us discuss about the interior of the right atrium. So observe here, this is the right atrium here, and this is the sternocostal surface, this is the arch of aorta. So the external features of the right atrium are, you know that muscular appendage is there, this is called as the right auricle, and you have a sulcus extending from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava. This is called as the sulcus terminalis. So these are the external features of the right atrium, and it is quadrilateral in shape. It is having an anterior and posterior parts inside, and interatrial septum is there inside the right atrium. So I have given a cut at the level of the right auricle here, and again one more cut near the anterior border of the right atrium, so that I have turned it to the lateral side. So this is the interior of the right atrium. So interior of the right atrium, it is having an anterior part, this is the anterior rough part, and posterior smooth part. So anterior rough part is nothing but it is called as the atrium proper, whereas posterior smooth part is called as the sinus venarum, because of the developmentally, you know that you have primitive heart tube is there from above downwards. Primitive heart tube is having bulgings called as the truncus arteriosus, bulbous cortex, primitive ventricle, primitive atrium, and sinus venosus. During the time of development, venous sinuses will be absorbed into the atrium, right atrium. So that part, the absorbed sinus venosus, we call it as the posterior smooth part. So because it is an absorbed sinus venosus, all the veins will be draining into the right atrium, posterior part of the right atrium. That is why we see the openings of the superior vena cava above this one, and below is opening of the inferior vena cava, and opening of the coronary sinus is seen. Coronary sinus is nothing but it's all the veins of the heart drains into the coronary sinus, and this coronary sinus drains into the right atrium. So you have the posterior smooth part, that is nothing but the absorbed sinus venosus. And if you take the anterior part, this is a rough anterior part, it is actual atrium, that is why it is called as the atrium proper. And the features of the anterior part are, you can see the horizontally going fibers, they are the musculi pectinate muscles. And just opposite to the sulcus terminalis, you have a raised ridge, you can see, that is called as the crista terminalis. This raised, if you touch it, you can feel the rigidness here, that is the crista terminalis. So this becomes the demarcation between the posterior part and the anterior part, crista terminalis. So these are the parts present in the anterior rough part. Whereas coming to the smooth part, you can see the, this is the opening of the superior vena cava, opening of the inferior vena cava, and opening of coronary sinus. There is no wall for the superior vena cava, but just below that you have a raised elevation, you can see, that is called as the intervenous tubercle is there. Intervenous tubercle, this is a place where SA node is present. And you have the valve of the inferior vena cava is there. That valve is called as the eustachian valve. And again, this is a coronary sinus. Even the coronary sinus is also linked, having a valve that is called as the tibiation valve. And the other features are, and you also see the small openings are there. Small openings you could able to see. They are called as the venae cordae minimus, and also anterior cardiac vein openings. So all the veins of the heart, they drain into the coronary sinus except two. They are the vena cordis minimi and the anterior cardiac vein. So anterior cardiac vein is draining blood from the infundibulum of the ventricle. So it directly drains into the right atrium. Whereas the vena cordis minimi, they are draining from the, all the chambers, and they drain into the, all the chambers of the heart. So these are the features of the posterior smooth part. Whereas if you observe this part, this is the interatrial septum, you can see. So interatrial septum also, we have some features are there. You can see this is a soft thin area that is called as the fossa ovalis, and this is bounded by the limbus fossa ovalis, anteriorly, posteriorly, and above. It is bounded by margins called as the limbus fossa ovalis. And these are nothing but fossa ovalis is embryologically, this is a remnant of the septum primum. whereas limbus fossa vagalis is a remnant of the lower part of the septum secundum. For this, you have to know the little development of the interatrial septum. So here I have made some pictures here. So this is the primitive atrium, this is primitive ventricle. There is a common chamber initially, atrioventricular canal we say, but after some time we have two endocardial cushions will be coming from anterior and posterior side, and they join in the middle. We call them as the septum intermedium, so that on either side we have the right AV canal and left AV canal. And after that, there is from the roof of the primitive atrium an extension from the endocardium extends downwards. It is sickle shaped fold. It comes near to the septum intermedium. This foramen is called as the ostium primum. And later on what happens is this septum primum, it fuses with the septum intermedium, leaving a degeneration above, a degeneration of the upper part by the apoptosis. Apoptosis is programmed cell death. So there is a gap above, whereas the septum primum fuses with the septum intermedium. Then after some time, you'll have the another extension from the roof just lateral to the venous walls or sinoatrial orifice. This is sinoatrial orifice I have drawn. Just left to that, another extension comes downwards and it grows downwards and it overlaps the septum primum. But it do not fuse with that, but it overlaps it and it comes near to the septum primum. So that you'll have a foramen here. So the blood from the right atrium, it enters into the left atrium like this. This is called as the ostium secundum. And after development or after the first try of the baby, this septum primum and septum secundum fuse with each other, forming an interatrial septum, and this ostium secundum will be closed permanently. And this septum primum, after closing, it gives an impression on the right atrium, that is called as the fossa ovalis. Whereas lower border of the septum secundum, it forms the limbus fossa ovalis. And coming to this sinoatrial orifice, it is having two walls here, right venous wall and left venous wall. Later on, this sinoatrial orifice becomes expanded. You see here, this is a right venous wall. It forms the crista terminalis and it forms the valve of the inferior vena cava and it forms the valve of the coronary sinus, the right venous wall. Whereas left venous wall, it merges with the interatrial septum. So keeping these things in mind, you should see here, this is a fossa ovalis. It is nothing but the remnant of the septum primum. Whereas this is limbus fossa ovalis, is remnant of the lower part of the septum secundum. And we have other features are there here. There is an elevation called as the torus aorticus. This is nothing but it is because of the non-coronary aortic sinus. We have aortic sinuses are there, anterior, right and left posterior aortic sinus. Anterior aortic sinus gives rise to right coronary artery. Left posterior aortic sinus gives rise to left coronary artery. Whereas right side posterior aortic sinus is not giving any arteries. So this gives a bulging here. That sinus is called as a non-coronary sinus. This bulging is called as a torus aorticus. And this is a AV orifice here. You could see this is a AV orifice, right AV orifice here. So here if you observe from the AV orifice, you just identify the AV orifice here and then coronary sinus here, and you have an endocardial ridge is there from the AV orifice towards the inferior vena cava, that is called as tendon of Todaro. So we have a triangle in between these three structures, between the AV orifice and the tendon of Todaro and coronary sinus. This triangle is called as a triangle of Koch. So here AV node is present in the triangle of Koch. So these are the structures present in the right atrium.